Hello and welcome to Stern Effects. My name is Eran Stern and this time we are going to use the GPU to speed up After Effects. Mercury GPU acceleration allows After Effects to render supported effects using your graphic card, which can significantly improve render time. In this tutorial, we'll put it to the test and also explain how this works with third-party effects and other technical stuff that you need to be aware of. Now, you may recognize the Mercury name from Premiere Pro. After Effects uses the same rendering component technology to accelerate performance. And I'm going to use this composition to demonstrate it. Now, what's unique about this composition is that I've used only GPU effects on different layers. So to test how well it performs, we need to, of course, enable GPU acceleration. Before I'm going to do that, let's render this using software-only mode. Then we can compare between the two. So I'm going to go to the Composition menu and then choose Add to Render Queue. I'm going to just leave the default settings as is. I'll click on the Output tool and just tell it to render on the desktop. Let's just click Save or OK if you're working on the PC, and then click on Render. This, of course, is going to use the multi-frame rendering to accelerate the render time. But again, all the GPU effects here are going to fall back to the CPU. Now, it's not so bad. The result here is 20 seconds, which is quite fast on this machine. Now let's see if we can accelerate it even further by using the Mercury GPU acceleration. Now this is a project setting, and to enable it, you'll either need to go to File and then Project Settings, or I'm just going to escape out of it. You can click on this tiny rocket at the bottom of the project panel. And this is going to open up the same menu, the same dialog. So instead of Mercury software only, I'm going to use this pop-up menu and select Mercury GPU acceleration in parentheses metal. Now, depending on your computer and GPU, you may see different options here. For example, you may see OpenCL, which is available for macOS and Windows, CUDA, which is Windows only with an NVIDIA GPU card, or metal, as you are seeing here, for macOS only, running 10.12 and later. I'm going to click OK over here, and I want to show you that in the Effects and Presets panel, if I'll click on it, you can isolate only the GPU-capable effects by going to the Options menu and choose this one from the list, Show GPU-capable effects only. This, of course, is going to reduce this list to show you only the supported effects. Now, I should also mention that some third-party effects like Element 3D by Video Copilot or Trickstore by Revision Effects also uses the GPU, but they are doing it independently of After Effects, so you may not see them on the list. However, third-party effects from Red Giant, for example, this Red Giant VFX category, are going to be here because they are hooked into the Mercury GPU acceleration pipeline, and therefore they will be visible. All right, so I'm going to close this category. And again, as I told you, in this composition, I'm only using built-in GPU effects, which makes it more responsive and faster to render. So this is also true even when I'm scrubbing the timeline, keeping my composition at full resolution. All right, so let's go to the beginning. And first, I'm just going to press spacebar to preview it so we can get a sense of the difference. And as you can see, this is working quicker than before, but we'll need to render it in order to compare. Now, before I'll do it, I'm also going to call your attention to this adjustment layer. Let's just pause the preview over here. And I've named it Immersive Effects after a few effects from the Immersive Video category. So currently it is switched off. I'll select again the timeline, and I'm going to enable it by pressing Command Option, Shift, V. This will be Control, Alt, Shift, V. This is just a nice keyboard shortcut to turn on and off the visibility of layers. And then I'll show you the effect controls. So we have a VR glow as well as a VR chromatic aberration, which hopefully you can see. I'm just going to zoom in, looks really nice. So all the VR effects, such as what you just saw, are working only on the GPU. If I'll return back to the project panel and then click on this little rocket, switch off the Mercury GPU acceleration, and then click OK, we're going to see this red message telling us that these effects require the GPU acceleration. All right, so let's just enable it again. And I'm also going to Option or Alt click once on this little guy to convert this project to 16 bits per channel. Now on the technical side, I'll just mention that a GPU with 4 GB of VRAM or higher is needed to use these effects. The advantage of the VR effects over the regular effects is that they are seamless, meaning that they wrap at the end of the image. However, some of them are very useful even on a non-VR footage because they have some features that are not available anywhere else in the program, such as what I showed you, the VR chromatic aberration, as well as the VR glow, which I really like. And you can also test other stuff here, such as the digital glitch and the color gradients, which offer 8 color stops of different gradients. Anyway, let's see how much it will take this comp to render with these effects switched on. Now I know this is not a fair comparison because I'm adding more stuff here and also raise the bit depth of this composition, but even though, I want to see how this is going to affect the render time. So I'll go to the beginning of the composition and I'll clear the cache. Then I'll add this composition again to the render queue by going to the same menu again, and I'll click the render button. And as you can see for yourself, the difference is quite impressive. So this composition took only 7 seconds to render. Now, before I let you go, there are a few more things worth mentioning. The first is the fact that layer transformations and motion blur are also GPU accelerated. So everything that you are seeing over here under the transform as well as motion blur. So depending on your comp, you may see a boost in performance even with no effect applied to the layer. I also want to point out that in a mixed CPU and GPU rendering environment, there is a performance cost to moving frames between CPU and GPU memory. So if an effect is not faster to render on the GPU than on the CPU, you will lose performance time while copying the frames back and forth. There's also an hardware accelerated composition, layer and footage panel options in the display preferences. And to show you what I mean, I'll go to the After Effects settings. You will find it under Edit Settings on the Windows side. And then I'll choose Display. And over here, you will see the hardware accelerated composition, layer and footage panels. So this is enabled by default. And this is using OpenGL to prepare the rendered frames for screen display during previews and playback. Once After Effects renders the frame, it next prepares that frame for display, taking into account the screen resolution, scaling, overlays like guides and layer handles, as well as color management. And this brings me to the last point over here, so I'll click OK. And return back to the project panel, click again on this little rocket and go to the color tab. So when you are using the color management for the project, either the Adobe Color Manage or the new OCIO Color Manage, After Effects is going to utilize the GPU to accelerate this process. Now the GPU requirement for this is very low, and any modern video card with small amount of VRAM is adequate. So as always, before I'll wave goodbye, I'm just going to maximize this composition, go to the beginning and preview this comp. While it is previewing, I will mention that with every release of After Effects, Adobe adds more effects to the list. So if you feel the need for speed, try using these GPU effects. But this is it for this time. If you like this video, then prove it by clicking on the appropriate button underneath. Perhaps also consider subscribing to the channel. It will really help me to create more content. In any case, thank you so much for watching and see you again soon.